Hello there. In this video, we are going to look at how to account for a receivable that's no longer deemed collectible. A customer may not be able to fulfill outstanding debt obligations for a variety of reasons, including bankruptcy, for example. When a firm sells on credit, it debits its accounts receivable account and it credits its revenue account. There is no 100% guarantee that this debt will be fulfilled, and the part of the debt that is uncollectible is called bad debt. We're going to look at two methods on how to account for bad debt. The first method is called direct write-off method, and the second method is called allowance method. In the direct write-off method, a journal entry for bad debt is made in the period in which the debt is deemed uncollectible. Let's consider an example here, okay? Imagine a sale on credit was made during the month of January for about $1,000. Okay, so the firm would record a debit of $1,000 under accounts receivable and would credit the revenue account by the $1,000. This increases their assets by $1,000 and revenue of $1,000 is shown on the income statement. Now let's say during the month of February, $20 is deemed uncollectible. So under the direct write-off method, the company would debit their bad debt expense account by that $20 and would credit their accounts receivable account by $20. Okay, this brings down the total receivables by $20, showing that this is deemed uncollectible. The bad debt expense of $20 ensures that the profit is not overstated. But we can already identify a problem here. The accounts receivable and revenues were recorded in the month of January, whereas the bad debt was written off only in the month of February. Under US GAAP or IFRS matching principle, our expenses have to be matched along with the revenue in the same period in which they are incurred. So by using the direct write-off method, we ended up overstating our assets in the balance sheet and also our total profit in the income statement during the month of January. So how can we fix that? If somehow the company can estimate how much of their receivables is uncollectible, then we can already make a provision during the month of January and say, look, this portion of my receivable is uncollectible, and we can make some journal entries to denote that. So let's say the company estimates $20 out of the receivables is uncollectible. The accounting for this provision is done in the month of January by debiting the bad debt expense account by $20 and by crediting a contra asset account known as the allowance for doubtful accounts. This contra asset account sits along with the accounts receivable under assets, but remember, it's a contra asset. So it reduces the value of the net accounts receivable. So if the accounts receivable was 1,000, by crediting an allowance for doubtful accounts by 20, we show that our net accounts receivable is only 980. And this net accounts receivable is reflected in the balance sheet during the month of January. Now, what happens during the month of February when the debt is deemed uncollectible? Because the bad debt expense account was debited already in the month of January, we don't have to make any further changes. But now, since the debt has been guaranteed to be uncollectible, we are going to reverse the provision we made, okay? We are going to debit the allowance for doubtful accounts by $20, okay? And now we are going to credit directly from the accounts receivable account by $20. Keep in mind that this journal entry during the month of February does not affect the net accounts receivable in any way, and by extension, does not impact the balance sheet in any way either. The provision made in the allowance for doubtful accounts can be adjusted across multiple time periods depending on the current balance of this account and further receivables. Okay, all this is great, but what happens once a debt has been written off as bad debt, but the customer eventually ends up paying later? Let's build on the same example. A customer who owed us $20, his debt was written off during the month of February. Okay. But consider a case where the customer now, during the month of March, decides to pay. Okay, he decides to pay the whole $20. How do we reverse a debt which has already been written off? We start by reversing the bad debt expense and increasing the accounts receivable again. Okay, so we're going to debit the accounts receivable by that $20, and we're going to credit the bad debt expense by $20. Once that journal entry had been made, because the customer pays in cash, we can further debit cash and credit accounts receivable to complete the transaction. When we discussed the allowance method, we agreed that firms can estimate their bad debt expense and hence make a provision. Okay. Now we're going to look at how firms can estimate their bad debt expense. There are two methods by which they can do that. The first method is the percentage of credit sales method, and the second method is the aging of receivables method. Under the percentage of credit sales method, a company simply applies a flat percentage as a bad debt estimate of the overall receivables. This percentage can be obtained from past experiences. For example, if the total credit sales was about $1,000 and a firm estimates that 3% of all credit sales or receivables should be deemed uncollectible, then they would estimate their bad debt to be 3% of that receivables. So $30 would be estimated as the bad debt. Once the estimate has been obtained, journal entries can be made using the allowance method we discussed earlier. Under the aging of receivables method, the company groups different receivables based on how much time has passed since the credit sale had happened and applies a percentage of estimated bad debt for each of these groups based on past experiences. Let's consider the following scenario. A company estimates that if the receivable is less than 30 days old, typically 1% of that debt is uncollectible. But if the debt is already 30 to 90 days old, the firm estimates that typically 3% is expected to be uncollectible. For debt which is already more than 90 days old, the firm estimates that 10% is typically uncollectible. Now let's say the receivables in each category was about $1,000, okay? And then we can calculate the estimated bad debt in each category by multiplying the percentage with the total receivable. Okay, and the total estimated bad debt is simply the sum of the three categories we just calculated. Okay, so the total estimated bad debt in this case is about $140. Once the bad debt has been estimated, we make a provision using the allowance method we discussed earlier. I hope this video helped you clear all your queries regarding bad debt accounting. If you still have any questions, feel free to reach out to me using the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Cheers.